Welcome to the Mischief. I'm Valen, and this is Embers. Today I'll be showing you the different kinds of epic weapons and tools you can make with this wonderful mod. Woo! So as you can see here, we have some really impressive looking tools and weapons to choose from. Now, these of course are no light items to be made or used, though you would think, well, if all I really need access to is Dawnstone, it's not that difficult, and what makes them so epic? Well, they have special requirements and have special properties. They are not enchantable, unlike your regular like Dawnstone items that you hear can enchant. Just for example's sake, let's put this Dawnstone sword in here. You can see that you can actually add in some different abilities onto them if you so desire. So the traditional Dawnstone tools and weapons will function similarly to your vanilla tools as far as enchanting, but these ones will not. But they have some significant differences that will make them much more worthwhile. So, to give an example, actually, before we get into examples, let's get into how these are actually going to work. They all require batteries, ember batteries to be specific, and you can actually take those with you. There are a couple different kinds. We've got our cartridges and we've got our jars. Now, they function the same way to power the tools, but they are actually going to give you different ways of doing so. Let's start off with the jar. Now, you see here I have a mantle jar. Holds 1,000 in it, and all you need to do is have this in your inventory, anywhere in your inventory. If you keep it in a bag in your inventory, it's not really going to function that way, but anywhere in your inventory or on your hotbar, or even in your shield slot, you can hold onto it there. It will power any of these tools. And it's a very simple recipe of just copper, a couple iron, an ember shard, and some glass. We'll get you one of those. And the other style is going to be this, the mantle cartridge, which you see here. It stores a lot more. You think, well, why not go with this? Well, the difference is, with a mantle cartridge, you have to have it in your shield slot for it to actually be powering these tools. So therefore, since none of the tools really will benefit from a shield as it is, you might as well probably go with this one, most likely, if you're going to be using your ember epic tools here. So it will store a lot more ember as well, and you'll find that you'll go through the ember quite quickly because it's just too much fun not to use the special abilities. But it's made with a couple iron ingots, copper plate, an ember crystal, not a shard, and three glass will get you a mantle cartridge. Now you're probably wondering, or if you haven't, you should be by now, how do I charge up these new items here, like the mantle cartridge? Well, that's where you make these here, copper chargers. Now, a copper charger is made simply by taking some copper ingots, an iron plate, a couple iron ingots, and another copper plate down here. We'll get you a copper charger. You can then put a receptor on there, same as you would with others. Allow me to grab a tinker hammer here. And of course, you'd start at the destination, shift right click, and you would right click, and it would therefore hook up to it. Now, this one here, I believe, is already full. Yes, it is. Holds 24,000 ember in it. So, if I need to charge up one of these cartridges or jars, let me get some. I'll get a couple empty ones here, and we'll just get rid of these full ones for the moment. And you can actually just right click. And it will start charging the item. Now I'm taking it back out. You can see it actually put 390 already in there. It does take a little bit of time. You can see that it's draining down slowly. I already have it currently hooked up so that it's replenishing. And of course in here I have a full one. So therefore that is how you'd recharge these items, which is really, really convenient. I like it. It's a very simple way of doing it. So that you can charge up a bunch of them. You could just fill your inventory with a bunch of mantle jars if you so desired and go with it from there. Personally, I think having a combination of the two is probably a good idea. Some of these for backup and one of these for your main to be used on in hand while you're doing this stuff. So for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to be keeping a mantle cartridge in my offhand just so that I don't need to worry about running out in my inventory or anything like that, or just filling up my inventory. Now, the different tools here. I currently have them in my inventory already. Let's start off with a clockwork axe. You can put it here and you can look at it with the eye of the ancients, as I showed in a previous video. And it basically will tell you that it is effective both as a weapon and as a means of breaking wooden blocks. When right-clicked, it can break a large area of wood blocks all at once. Well, Let's grab one of these things here. And you can see that the attack damage on there is the same as your typical, like, a diamond axe, which is, you know, 9 damage. Let's actually look at a diamond axe from your vanilla game here, and it's 1 and 9, 1 and 9. So it functions in exactly the same way. But if I didn't have the mantle cartridge, let's just toss that out. It still functions as a weapon, you know, but I don't gain access to any of its secondary abilities. So by equipping this and then having the clockwork axe, I then can use its secondary ability. Now, I don't have any wood in front of me, but you'll notice that there will be a recharge bar on the axe itself in my hotbar. There we go. I actually had to aim at something for it to happen. You saw a little particle effect on the ground, and that's its recharge before it can actually be used again for that ability. So let's go find some trees here and go use this. All right, here we are. I've got some, I think these are oak saplings, and there's a spruce there, and you can, you know, still just chop really quickly with this. I mean, it is very effective for that. Or you can just right click and just demolish the entire tree very simply. You know, there you go. Uses up a little bit of the cartridge, as you can see here, you know, 5895. I've been using it a little bit. And of course, it will just destroy trees in an area. It doesn't go all the way up. Like it said, it will destroy wood in an area. So to highlight that further, allow me to build a large block of wood to show you how much it would destroy. All right, here we go. I now have a 5 tall by 6 by 6 square, well, kind of a rectangle, really, of the desired, well, wood, so that we can demonstrate this a little bit. And I'm going to just stand in the middle-ish here, and I'm going to right-click. Wow, and you can see a large area has been taken out. That was me aiming down from the above, and it just demolished a huge area of wood. Boom. So you realize now that it will take out a large chunk. It doesn't go up too high, about 5 blocks or so. So you might have some wood left over, like this one here. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So let's aim at the bottom. And you'll see that it only went up so far. But as far as demolishing a lot of wood blocks, it can do a huge area of effect. And then you can just use it to do the rest of that. And you notice it actually doesn't take any damage either. None of these epic tools will take damage. That is one of the big advantages. You don't need to worry about that unbreaking enchantment anymore with these. You just need to power them and have them created, and they will last you. You cannot enchant them, but hey, you know what? They come with their own built-in enchantment-like abilities, which are really, really epic. So let's move on to something a little bit more interesting. We've got our Clockwork Pickaxe. And yes, these things are massive tools. Look at this. It is huge. I mean, come on. It's awesome. You get your little tiny hammer and your huge pickaxe. It's great. So you can really have a lot of fun with this. Kind of almost like an anime exaggeration style here. But it's really effective. So, of course, let's start mining a little bit with this pickaxe. You know, you've got your standard pick rate. It's not too bad. And no, it doesn't have a built-in magnet. I've got a magnet turned on right now. But if I so choose, I can use its secondary ability, which, of course, it works just fine in its mining speed and everything like that. But I can also, boom, do a 3x3x2 deep area. So I could actually use this in a similar fashion to the hammer. It does take a second or two for it to recharge, so you can't just spam it nonstop. But it can be very effective for mining. Let me grab a few ores and I will demonstrate. All right, I've got a few ores here. We can just place them down. Some emerald, obsidian, diamond, gold, iron, lapis. I think I've got some redstone in here too. So let's put that down and then let's use its ability. Oh, hey, not a problem. What's that? Instant harvesting of obsidian? Oh, it's just too good. You could always mine it out your old-fashioned way, but personally, I prefer the old standard way of using an epic tool to just, you know, destroy it in no time flat. So there you go, the pick, which is quite excellent. And of course, again, no durability loss on that. You just need to power it with a bit of ember if you want to use its any of its abilities. Now, if I don't have this mantle cartridge with me, keep in mind, I've got my clockwork pickaxe. It's like I'm trying to mine the ground with my hands. It may be even less, but if I do have it, then it's not a problem. Of course, I need to equip it because that's that one there. There we go. then it's not a problem to do so. So remember, these do have to be powered. That is their one weakness. Now let's move on to, let's say, a little bit more of a melee-type item here. Now this thing here is pretty darn epic, the Grandhammer. It is also the biggest tool. Look at this thing. It is huge. It's going to just destroy your enemies as well. So I've set up this little area here for a future demonstration for something else, but I'm going to use it for this as well. So there we go. They all took a little, like a half-hearted damage just from spawning in inside of the dispensers, but don't worry about that. Let's try hitting one of these guys, and you saw there, it took away more than half of his health. Of course, they're all very upset, but I mean, I'm just attacking normal. Just one hit will only hit one guy. Well, what happens if I right-click with this? Oh my gosh. It does a huge area sweep effect and will hit nearby enemies. Now, it does take a bit for it to come back, but I mean, seriously, I just like two hit like 20 pigmen or something like that. It is ridiculous. So this is kind of a much more balanced version of a Draconic Evolution style weapon here in my mind. So don't be afraid to run around with this one in your inventory. It's going to have a really good attack rate on its own, which is 11, much better than, you know, your regular swords, which are around like 7, I think, for a diamond. But then you can always put protection on those. The Grandhammer, of course, it will just be an 11. You can't add extra abilities on there, but it already has its own ability for just like kicking butt on bad guys. I mean, come on. It's also really impressive to just have this giant thing running around and smack your foes with it. It's so good. All right, let's get into some of the other stuff here. We currently have the Blazing Ray, which this one here is a lot of fun as well. Now this one, I see a potential target here. Let me try it. Just take him out. And we just shoot them. Pew pew. It's laser guns, laser beams. You can just take out your foes without any problem. Now there's I think a glitch in it right now where it currently has perfect accuracy no matter what. But this may change over time. It's supposed to be when you pull it back, it has better accuracy at a further distance. But you know, it all depends on how you do it. And you see, I'm just laying waste to these guys. It does about 3.5 hearts, I think, of damage to it. So it's really good, and I realize that there's no sound for it, but you know what, I kind of like that, because it actually will not annoy me as much either, because you know I want to spam this thing, because it's a long range spammy gun. It's just really good, really good. Now each shot, of course, does use up quite a bit, and you notice that this is probably the most significant use that I've had so far of my Mantle cartridge. Just using it on these guys, but I mean, heck, you could always carry a couple Mantle cartridges around. And some a point of just a little tip: if you notice, I'm aiming at this sheep, and I'm going to shoot him, and I hit him. I got lucky on that one. Often you have to actually aim a little bit lower than where you think you need to aim. Like if I aim just right here, actually I was wrong. But anyway, if you find yourself not hitting it, aim a little bit higher, because the crosshair might be a little bit off center for the occasional thing, or it just might be me. I don't know, but it's really a lot of fun. And of course, I haven't been telling you guys the recipes. They are very simple for the axe. It's a couple dawnstone ingots, a couple dawnstone plates, copper, ember shard, and stick. The pickaxe is dawnstone ingots, ember shard, copper, and stick. I mean, these aren't that bad. The hammer, of course, a couple dawnstone blocks, dawnstone ingot. Copper ingot and a stick. The Blazing Ray here, which I think is a lot of fun. It's not very overpowered, in my opinion. You can fairly well spam it, you know, within reason, but you also have a really good ranged weapon here. Dawnstone plates, couple dawnstone ingots, iron ingot, stick, and an ember shard. And then last but not least, we have here cooked mutton. Now, let me clear this crap out of my inventory from all these sheep that died. We have here the Cinder Staff, which, allow me to demonstrate this. It's going to be a couple silver plates, ember shard, two dawnstone ingots, and a couple sticks. Now, the Cinder Staff is a little bit different. That's the one that you saw me with at the beginning of the video. This one here, I can shoot. Pachoo! Just a tiny little bit of energy here. It's not that impressive. I mean, you can see this little tiny thing, or I can charge it up, and it can get really, really big. I mean, look at this thing. It's ridiculous. And then, and you can see that just shooting off like a comet. It's pretty cool. Now, you'd think, you know, something looking like that, it might do area of effect. It really doesn't. It actually just hits one target. But the more you charge it up, the more damage it does. And it can do a considerable more, it can do considerably more damage to foes than the Blazing Ray can. Blazing Ray is like 3.5 standard. The Cinder Staff is somewhere around 8 or 9 hearts of damage from one fully charged up shot. But then again, it does shoot very slowly. So by the time that's going, you could probably get a few shots on something that's further away with the Blazing Ray. So it's all dependent on how you want to go with this. It's more kind of an immersion thing for you then at that point. You know, if you want to do laser guns or if you want to use a magic staff, you've got your options on in this case. And they're fantastic options at that. Let me just eat a little snack there. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video today on the epic weapons and tools of Embers. I know I had a lot of fun with it, and I look forward to incorporating this into my own gameplays as well, potentially putting it on my own servers and stuff. But it's a lot of fun. These are really, really creative weapons that I don't think are too overpowered, especially in comparison to other modded stuff out there at this point. It just gives you a few other options that you can go with. So, anyway, don't forget to give a like, comment below, subscribe if you haven't already, and always spread the mischief to others if you think they'll enjoy this content. And until next time, folks, see ya.